never known you to be one who does what you say you'll do. I have only ever found you faithful. Every shadow, every sorrow, you have met my heart with open hands. My tomorrow, love's already planned.
Welcome to a brand new episode. As I always promise you, every week I bring you amazing content in my ability, in my capability. In this week's episode, as you can see, I have an amazing young talent here, the artistic young man by the name Thompson Oramezi. So join me, chill, and enjoy this amazing conversation that I'll be having with Mr. Thompson Oramezi. Thompson, welcome, and how are you doing?
Thank you very much. I'm good.
You're good?
I'm good. Thank you for inviting me first.
It is a great honor for me to have you here, you know, because you're such an incredible young person. You are a true definition of what it means to be young and daring. It always makes me curious because you're famously known in the UB community for being an artist. Mutaiki, you are like. But despite being Mutaiki, you're doing a very difficult program, medicine. Can you tell me what is it about? Or how did you come to link medicine and art? Or maybe how do you even manage to shuffle between the two?
Okay. I don't know if you've read what you want. They like to say that art, medicine is art. I don't know if you've read that. Mm-hmm. And I want to believe that too. And what I'm trying to prove is that, you know, art can also be medicine.
Yeah.
So I think that's why I try to, you know, intertwine the truth.
Intertwine the truth, yes.
Yeah. And that's where the passion is derived from. Yeah.
So at what age did you discover that you're an artistic person?
I think it was in primary, standard 5. Mm-hmm. I used to draw, you know, anime, cartoons, Dragon Ball. But my drawings were more, I took time, but they were more detailed.
Mm-hmm.
They had a bit more form, value. I don't know if you know those terms, but it just means the idea and all that.
Yeah.
I took time with them.
Oh. Then you carried on with art until senior school
till now. I'm still drawing.
So at school, were you excelling? Like, did you even do it as a subject? And how did you perform in art?
Yeah, I always tried to balance, you know, art and sciences because those are my favorite.
Oh, you love sciences?
Yeah, like I always try to get A's both sides.
Now it makes sense why you are into medicine.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Always love science and art.
Ladies and gentlemen, like I said earlier, I'm here with a young, amazing artist, Thompson Oramezi. This young man can do miracles with just a pencil. He will take a pencil and he will build mountains with just a pencil. That's how talented he is. So join us as we continue with our conversation. Thompson Oramezi, my artistic young man. Now let's talk about you coming here in UB, right? This young person who's got the art in you, right? You have art inside of you, in your soul. And then you come here in University of Botswana, you study medicine. Medicine is considered to not be a child's play. You know, I know a lot of people who study medicine who will tell you that because they're doing medicine, they do not even have like a life. You know, you live for medicine. It's all about understanding histology and all this anatomy and all that. So for you, it's quite fascinating that despite being in the medicine school or in the school of medicine, you still find time to do what you love compared to other kids who do medicine. Is it because you are talented, maybe academically, you find it easy to, you know, do well in academics while at the same time having art on the side? What's your secret?
I wouldn't say I'm talented or what.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's based on, you know, making decisions. It's mm-hmm. a choice.
Mm-hmm.
I think I chose to choose.
Mm-hmm.
I chose to choose to, you know, do what makes me happy.
Mm-hmm.
I know I can, you know, work hard and try to get 80%, 89%, 90%. Mm-hmm. I know I can try to do that.
Do that.
But it's not worth my happiness, you know, sacrificing other parts of me.
Yeah.
You know, I need those pieces of puzzle, you know,
to form a whole picture that makes you.
Yeah. So I guess it's just me deciding that.
Indeed, happiness is a choice.
Exactly.
You decide to not sacrifice your happiness and the things that make you happy at the expense of just one thing. Now let's talk about you just being chosen, because the art you do is incredible. It's incredible, and you do it passionately. There's this consistency that we see. Right? The moment someone goes on your Facebook page, Thompson Art, and also on Instagram, every week you post something to do with your artistic work. You know, one would not even be able to pick that. This is a medical doctor in the making.
Yeah.
The art is like
yeah.
the one dominating in your pages.
Yeah.
And also your name, just the moment you hear Thompson, you're associated with art.
Yeah.
Right. What does art mean to you?
Let me try to explain this from the field, you know, from the medical view. You know, once I draw, I think artist is a drug to me.
It's a drug.
I consider it a drug.
Mm-hmm.
Once I draw, it's like somebody taking an alcohol or
it's an antidote.
Something like that. Like that. Because once I draw, you know, the things, happy chemicals, dopamines in your brain, they start to stimulate you to your brain. It's called a reward system.
Mm-hmm.
Your brain starts to make you feel happy.
Mm-hmm.
Once you're happy,
it's neuroscience.
Exactly. Become productive and all of that. So I believe art is a drug to me.
Yeah.
When I'm tired after reading, I need to take a drug.
The drug.
And it boosts it.
It helps you to keep going.
Exactly.
Okay, so one would love to know, Thompson, because everyone has a story. Every one of us has a story. Every one of us has something that, you know, drives them, motivates them, or inspires them to work hard every day and wake up and be like, I'm not giving up on the things that I'm doing. I'm not giving up on school. Giving up on
that.
So for you, what's the one thing that,
you know,
motivates you every morning
when you wake up? I think I've set goals that I really want to achieve.
Mm-hmm.
Like in everything I get on to be the first person to do that,
mm-hmm.
the first person to achieve that, the first person to be having that expensive part, to be the first person to be having that kind of hospital or that kind of
something.
I think that's what's going to motivate. That's motivating.
So chances are you're going to be our first, I don't want to say Leonardo da Vinci, but our very first Thompson,
along
those lines.
Yeah. Basically, that's it.
Wow.
One of the people I looked up to.
So what do you do now when you are not doing art, when you're not doing school? Which other hobbies, talents, and just activities do you do on the side?
I love sports.
You love sports?
Mm-hmm.
What sport do you play?
I do taekwondo.
Oh.
Like, when I'm in school, I'm learning.
You're studying?
I started last year, but then Corona, you know.
Yeah.
I should have had a yellow belt or something, you know.
You're headed for the black one. Is the black one the school one?
Just one.
So you don't want it?
I want it, but you know, I don't know if I'm going to achieve it.
Because of the pandemic. Well, I believe you do it.
Yeah.
You're very charming as well.
Yeah.
You know, it's one thing to do amazing things and be appreciated in your own community, in your own environment, in your own country. Like we've seen you making these portraits for some of our local celebrities, the likes of William Last. And, you know, it was just beautiful how even the guy was appreciating the drawing that you did for his daughter. But now, it's another thing now, when that recognition, when that sense of being celebrated goes beyond borders. We saw you on your Instagram where you made a drawing of this other South African artist, Carlton.
Carlton.
Carlton Essay.
Yeah.
Right. How did you do that? Because it's major.
Yeah. I don't want to believe that drawing was my best drawing. But the feeling, the celebration, like you say, it was the best feeling ever. And then, I don't know, my cousin gave me like Carlton Essay's number. And then I sent him a message that I really love your music, keep doing what you're doing.
What you do.
And then he's like, wow, okay. Thompson's Michael, Carlton
Essay.
And then he saw, I don't know where he saw, I think he started seeing my statuses on WhatsApp.
Mm-hmm.
And then he visited my page.
Oh.
And And then he asked me to make a portrait of him. I was really hesitating because I was, I don't know, I was caught up with a lot of schoolwork. Then
you wanted it for free.
He's still saying that he would give me something. I don't know if it's that.
It's
or
true.
It's true, man.
I hope you will do that.
And then I did that after, I think it was after 2 months or I tried to draw him and then just took the stage. And he really loved it.
Yeah, it was just beautiful. Just beautiful. My viewers, from here you're going to see the art that we're talking about that Mr. Thompson made of the essay, artist, cartooning essay. It's just beautiful. So stay tuned. You don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell, and be part of the Vision Squad family. In today's episode, like I said, I have the Thompson Poor Remittance.